Welcome to the MasterCars Pro channel. Today we will talk about the problems and weaknesses of this wonderful car. We're starting with the power units as usual.
The G15 Elmera was equipped with K4M 16-valve straight 4 only. It had 102 horsepower and 145 Nm of torque. This engine was developed by Renault and successfully used on Logan, Duster and Megane models. The engine is quite durable and repairable. Its problems are already well known on post-Soviet territory, and this engine is outrageously easy to maintain. Timing mechanism is belted and needs to be replaced every 60,000 km. Engine runs under Euro 4 emission standards and 91-octane fueling can be used. You can easily upgrade your engine by applying of 94-octane fuels, although the engine is rather powerless for such a heavy and large car. Problems often occur with electric sensor, especially crankshaft position sensor, excessive oil consumption and noises while running. First cars had troubles with variable valve timing gears. Oil dipstick is made of low quality plastic and can easily break. Upper coolant pipe is not sealed firmly and can have coolant leaks. Same problem can occur in fuel system. Gasoline can run away through clamp joints. Misfire is also a big problem of these engines. Ignition coils, spark plugs or injectors are major reasons to that. Also, piston ring failure can cause this. Common problems is unstable operation of the idle RPM due to bad throttle sealing and air leaks. Lower engine mount fails at 150,000 km. Other minor problems are common too, but fixed without major expenses. 5-speed manual JH3 and 4-speed auto DP2 were the only two gearboxes available for the N15 Elmera. GH3 gearbox is one of the cheapest on Renault Nissan and one of the most sensitive. Major problems are noisy operation, loose assembly, oil leakage through inner left CV joint after 60,000 km mileage and early failure of synchronizers. Reverse gear may be shifted with crusty sound on cars of 100,000 mileage and more. Input shaft bearing fails at 200,000 km and it's better be replaced in time to avoid expensive repairs. Gearbox lifetime is about 250 km, but if you maintain it better than recommended by manufacturer, it can run up to 400 to 450,000 km. Auto gearbox is a minorly improved version of DP0 gearbox, well known by fans. Improvements, however, did not solve all of its problems. The main disadvantage is slow gear shifting, accompanied with kicks and noises from torque converter zone. Slow shifting is caused by pressure sensor failure. As it fails, it begins to transfer wrong data that leads to errors in transmission control unit and bad gearbox functioning. At more than 100,000 km mileage, solenoid valves begin to fail, causing problems with gear shifting. Solenoid lifetime depends on driving manners. Valve body is also sensitive to overload. High temperature causes aluminium alloy housing meltdown. The quicker you repair components, the better. Waiting can lead to complete transmission repair. Experienced car mechanics recommend changing ATF every 60 to 80 km to significantly improve gearbox durability. It can be increased up to 200 to 300,000 km. Suspension ball joints are rather weak and should be replaced at 50 to 70,000 km. Owners admit that shock absorber seals have damages already at 30 to 50,000 km. Wheel bearing and steering linkages fail at less than 100,000 km or 150 if it's smoothly driven. Shock absorber support bearings and rubber bushings can run up to 100 to 120,000 km. Rear suspension is pretty good, but it can produce noises at bumpy roads. Shock absorber upper mount bearing get broken. Frequent transportation of three adult men on rear seats will make your change coil springs at 100 to 120,000 km. G15 Elmera is equipped with steering rack and hydraulic power steering. Rack lifetime is 200,000 km with no major problems. Steering mechanism is not very informative and power steering sensor seal may have leakages. Brake system is the weakest part of this car. Brakes operate badly, discs and pads are worn pretty quickly. Common problems is brake lines breach caused by high tensions at maximum steering angles. Hydraulic line can be friction worn in contact with subframe. It can be solved by loosely hanging long hydraulic lines installation. Discs also quickly get corroded. Handbrake cables often get out of plastic mountings. Car interior is very similar to first generation Logan with almost no improvements in assembly and material quality. Hot cheap plastic cloth seats and non-symmetric installation. Gauge panel has bleak and annoying lighting, so info is not quite readable and its top part is covered by steering wheel. Rear seats cannot be transformed in pre-restyling cars. Also front seats and seatbelt mounts did a creaking sound. Driver seat becomes wobbly at 100,000 km mileage. Interior has some ergonomic problems such as inconvenient signal, seat heating, window lift and mirror adjusting buttons location. No actual steering column adjustment, little storage space. Noise insulation is also weak. As a car of economy class, Almera does not have problems with electronics due to its poor trimming. Interior space is heated pretty slowly. Wiper and windscreen heating mode switch is rather fragile. Check engine sign can appear on the gauge panel with no reason. Lighting lamps are not quite durable, as well as window control and airbag control unit. Paint job on this car is pretty sensitive to mechanical action and easily scratches and breaks.
Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that will help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.